Hello, my name is Tomáš. I'm a PhD student at Georgia Tech, and today I'm going to talk about GeneMark ETP+, an automatic eukaryotic gene prediction algorithm which integrates genomic, transcriptomic, and protein evidence. GeneMark ETP+ solves the task of structural genome annotation. Just to give you a bit of background, the goal of this task is to predict the genomic locations and precise exon intron structures of protein-coding genes using some or all commonly available data sources. These are the genomic sequence itself, long or short RNA reads, protein database, or annotation of repeats. When designing our algorithm, we were following two main design principles. First, we wanted a tool that doesn't require any parameter adjustments. This means that the training of all models needs to be done in an unsupervised manner. Secondly, we wanted to combine all the sources of information. The common information sources used in gene prediction can be divided into three categories. First, transcript evidence, which supports expressed genes. Second, protein evidence, which supports evolutionary conserved genes. And finally, some genes may lack both the transcript and protein evidence, and they can only be predicted ab initio, based on the statistical patterns of the genomic sequence itself. It is important to know that each of these information sources contains a lot of noise, both of biological and technical nature. In summary, to precisely predict a complete gene set, a gene prediction tool needs to consider a combination of all of these types of evidence. With the previously mentioned design considerations in mind, we developed GeneMark ETP+. Here is a brief outline. The algorithm starts by inferring a set of reliable gene structures directly from the protein and transcript evidence. The resulting reliable genes, also called high-confidence genes, are used to split the genome into non-overlapping fragments. After that, a species-specific model is trained to predict genes in the fragments between high-confidence genes. All sources of transcript and protein evidence, even less reliable ones, such as alignments of remotely homologous proteins, are used to improve the final predictions in the genomic fragments. Let's take a closer look at the statistical model training, which is important for predicting genes without strong external support. The model parameters are first estimated from the initially selected high-confidence genes. Depending on the amount and quality of the external evidence, this might not be a large enough set to train a reliable model. Therefore, the model is further refined by rounds of iterative self-training. In each training iteration, genes are predicted in the fragments between high-confidence genes. The model parameters are then re-estimated based on ab initio predicted gene elements that are in agreement with the external transcriptomic or proteomic evidence. This self-training is repeated until convergence. I have mentioned high-confidence genes several times. To reiterate, these genes are used for splitting the genome into fragments and for the estimation of initial model parameters. Furthermore, they are also integrated into the final gene prediction set. For all these reasons, these genes must represent correct gene structures with as few deviations as possible. The prediction of the high-confidence genes involves transcript assembly from short reads or direct mapping of transcripts to the genome in case of long reads. An unsupervised algorithm, GeneMark ST, is then used to predict coding regions directly in the transcripts. At this step, we create a set of high-confidence gene candidates whose translations are aligned against a protein database. The gene predictions supported by protein alignment are selected as the high-confidence genes. GeneMark ST prediction scores are used during the filtering step. High-scoring GeneMark ST predictions are selected for the refined high-confidence set, even if the supporting protein match is relatively weak, possibly originating from a remotely related protein. Conversely, GeneMark ST low-scoring predictions are selected to the refined set only when they receive strong protein support. The table shows how well these filterings work for fruit fly, one of the tested species. While the raw set of all high-confidence gene candidates contained about one false prediction per every two correct ones, the refined high-confidence gene set is mostly noise-free. As you can see, only a small fraction of correctly predicted gene candidates were lost during the selection. Now let's take a look at the results. We evaluated the performance of GeneMark ETP+ on three genomes from different taxonomic phyla and compared the prediction accuracy with the three previous versions of the GeneMark algorithm, which utilize only individual sources of evidence. As you can see, GeneMark ETP+ correctly predicts about 80% of all annotated coding exons in each genome. The differences between algorithms are more pronounced when evaluated on the gene level. In this type of evaluation, the prediction is considered correct only when the full annotated and predicted gene structures exactly match. The results show that the combination of protein and transcript input in GeneMark ETP Plus is most beneficial for improving the predictions of genes in complex large genomes with a larger percentage of non-coding DNA and longer introns such as Dania rario, the zebrafish. For example, compared to GeneMark ETP Plus, the next best performing algorithm, the gene level sensitivity is almost twice as high. In summary, GeneMark ETP Plus is fully automatic, i.e. species and evidence-specific models used in the algorithm are trained in an unsupervised manner. Secondly, it utilizes several common sources of extrinsic evidence, short and long RNA reads, a protein database, and repeat annotation in both model training and gene prediction. And finally, it significantly improves on the algorithms using only individual evidence sources. These improvements are most notable in complex large genomes. We are currently finishing the implementation and testing of the algorithm and preparing a paper for publication. This research has been conducted in Dr. Mark Borodovsky's bioinformatics lab with Alex Lomsadze and Dr. Borodovsky himself. And finally, this research was funded by an NIH grant. Thank you for listening.